This is Craters of the Moon National Monument in southern Idaho. This vast expanse of very young basaltic lava forms this sort of absolutely magical and amazing volcanic landscape here in southern Idaho. Of course, the Snake River Plain is dominated by lava flows, but it's here at Craters of the Moon where we see the youngest volcanic features and probably the most diverse and fascinating types of volcanic landforms in the region. So this area formed mainly, the main eruptive face here with these very young lava flows formed with 8 eruptions over the last 15,000 years, with the youngest one being about 2,000 years ago. And the recency of the eruptions combined with the dry, arid climate that we have here in southern Idaho makes this landscape look like it's very fresh and as if it has had erupted quite recently. 2,000 years is, of course, pretty young geologically, and because it hasn't been vegetated or extensively weathered, we still get a really good view at a volcanic landscape that looks, you know, as if it had erupted within the last few years or so. What we're going to do here with this video is dive down into one of the lava tubes in the monument. First, you know, we've got some of these small hills over here. These are all cinder cones. These are places where lava erupted from the ground. It was a little bit gas rich, and so these clots of lava just piled up around the vent of the volcanoes to form these low hills here in the middle ground. These are cinder cones. The biggest one in the monument's over here. This is Big Cinder Butte. In other places in the monument, the lava wasn't quite as charged with gas, and so it erupted through fissure events, forming lava flows that just poured across the landscape here. This lava flow I'm standing on here with these fascinating sort of textures in it, this is the Blue Dragon lava flow. It's about 2,000 years old. In places, we'll see if we can find a good spot. In some places, it has kind of a very kind of cool, vibrant blue color that formed where there's a little bit of titanium in the lava that gives it this kind of unique color. But this is a lava tube called Indian Tunnel. And what's nice about Indian Tunnel is you can kind of go down into it without a flashlight. You can actually work your way through it without a flashlight because sections of it have collapsed and there's enough ambient light in the lava tube that you can actually see your way through it without a flashlight. So we'll get down here to the bottom and kind of just poke around a little bit. You can right away see the overall shape of the lava tube is kind of this semicircular arch shape kind of going in both directions here. This is pretty typical of lava tubes in terms of their shape. Of course, lava tubes form where we have a molten lava at the surface. The upper few inches of the lava flow crusts over because it's in contact with the air and leaves the interior of the flow kind of molten. Hello. Hi there. And so the rest of the lava flow continues to travel beneath the surface because rock is a really good insulator. Eventually, the eruption kind of dies down, the supply of lava wanes, and you're left with a hollowed out tube in the lava flow. And that is what forms these lava tubes. Ultimately, these lava tubes are not very stable. If you've ever been in one, they don't last very long geologically. Maybe a few million years at the most. They're prone to collapse. And right here in front of me, we can see a section of the tube with a little skylight above it. And you can see all the rubble down below. So this is where the lava tube ceiling has actually collapsed in on itself. And even as we look kind of up above here, we can see some of these fractures and cracks running through the ceiling of the cave. This part of Idaho gets some pretty good winter weather. It gets cold enough for ice to form. And so you can imagine in the fractures of the lava tube and the rock here, the constant freeze-thaw cycles that take place as the snow drips down, as water gets into those fractures, it ends up splitting apart the rock into these kind of big blocks we have down here, kind of in this broken zone. So we're gonna work our way up a little further. This is a pretty accessible section of lava tube. There's some other lava tubes in the park that you do need a headlamp or a flashlight to get through. They haven't collapsed as much. But Indian Tunnel, again, is pretty nice because it's got enough ambient light to work through. I'm gonna hit here real quick. I don't know how well this will look. We're gonna hit a dark section. Maybe I'll turn on my phone camera here. And this will actually maybe help us see a little bit better because this section can be pretty dark. That's a little better. This is just the one section that's a little bit dark, a little tricky to see your feet through here. But we're gonna work up to a place where we can see some other geologic features. Lava tubes are pretty fascinating because they form very differently than a lot of caves. A lot of the caves we have in the world are limestone caves, meaning they formed where limestone has dissolved out, or excuse me, water, groundwater has dissolved out the underlying limestone. And so it's more of a dissolution process, dissolving the rock material. And then as that water drips through the cave, it leaves behind stalactites and stalagmites, other features that kind of make the cave kind of ornamental and attractive. Lava tubes can have a lot of similar features. In fact, right here, we can kind of see some drip features along the roof of the cave. But instead of dissolved mineral material and groundwater dripping down, these are actually formed by lava dripping down off the ceiling of the cave. So you kind of get these interesting kind of, sometimes they're called shark tooth textures, just drip features from the ceiling of the cave while it's draining down. The other thing we can kind of see over here, just kind of move over here. There's a better place further ahead, but these are pretty good. We can actually also see places in here where the lava on the walls of the cave has kind of remelted the walls and sort of just dripping and oozing down the sides of the lava tube. So you can kind of see some interesting textural features there. I'm going to scramble over this broken section here where the lava tube cave has collapsed. So we have another skylight here, another open section where the lava tube's collapsed. We'll kind of work up through here. The footing is a little tricky. Bring trekking poles if you need them. And we'll go into, I believe there's one last collapse section before we get to a really nice spot to see some really cool features on the roof of the lava tube. So we're kind of getting back down here. Some of the colors we have in here could be mineralization from the water moving through that. Some of this looks like it's also lichen. So some of these bright yellows are lichen, which are like a cyanobacteria fungi kind of mixture that occurs together. So up ahead, one more collapse feature. It's a little tiny skylight up there in the roof. And then as we look above us, we can see not as many of the lava stalactites, but definitely really nice drip features kind of coating the wall where the lava kind of oozed down. So one more scramble through here. So if you come to Indian Tunnel, take a left at the bottom of the stairs if you want to kind of retrace my steps here. And rather than going back out the way you came, there's a way to actually climb out and exit the cave. One of the things we can see here, down there we can see a lower level and then an upper level. Sometimes tubes are actually nested. So as the lava flows through the tube, it's so hot that it's thermally eroding the ground beneath it. So you can get sort of multiple levels of a lava tube. So that one probably doesn't go very far because it's collapsed, but we can kind of see two possible levels there. We can also see down here along this one, some kind of horizontal lines running through running along the right side of the tube, kind of forming benches. So again, as the lava continues to thermally heat up and erode, cut through the rock below it, it leaves behind these kind of benchmarks or these little benches along, or levees, if you will, kind of along the sides of it here. So we'll get through this last little section here. Becomes a little more shallow here. The roof of the cave is more directly above us. Of course, in the floor of the lava tube, we have these nice pohoihoi, smooth, ropey flow textures here. And then this part's kind of my favorite. This last little skylight we can crawl through has a little kind of side channel off to the right. So we're going to kind of go up through this little thing, which is just big enough to fit into. But in here we get some really, kind of looking up at the ceiling of the cave now, really remarkable lava drip features, really nice texture. And then in the walls of the cave over here, we just get some fantastic drip features where the lava kind of oozed and ran down the sides of the tube to form these wonderful textures here. And then this is the spot where you got to kind of watch your head kind of pop up and then make one last move to get up and out of it. So we'll kind of pop up here above for one last look at the the landscape here.